Hi guys, in this video, I will show my Asus ROG Strix's first experience, performance test results, and unboxing. As always, Amazon shipping was excellent. Despite the 14-hour flight distance, it arrived well before the estimated day. It comes with international warranty, I like it, you can check the coverage list. It supports eGPU, which means I can use it with an external RTX 3090 in the future. The AC adapter is a little big, it complies with international standards with 100 volt between 20 to 40 volt support. I don't like plugs with thin ends that go into the laptop, it is very easy for them to break. When I touched this laptop, I realized that the monitor was sitting on a metal frame and it looked very solid. It is a 17.3-inch laptop, but I think it will be easy to fit in a laptop bag since the monitor edges are thin. Except for the RGB lights on the keyboard, about one-third of the front and sides of the laptop case are filled with RGB lights, it looks very stylish. It would have been more useful to me if it had an SD card reader instead of the RGB light. The 144Hz screen is very enjoyable when playing games. With one of the best CPU and one of the best GPU, the gaming fun is incredible. I've already added two game performance tests to this video, you can see it. It has four USB ports, two on the side and one on the back, and Type-C USB on the back. The metal monitor frame looks really stylish. According to the official info, the USB ports are USB 3.2, but I couldn't understand why, it seems 3.1 on my system. I will test the USB speed as soon as possible. I don't have a USB 3.2 supported device at the moment. I really like the sound quality of this laptop. I just realized that my old laptop has no sound. It sounds almost like a TV. Judging by the position of the screws, it looks like if I want to add RAM, I have to open the bottom completely, but luckily there are not many screws. This model does not have a web camera, but it has a microphone. I preferred a clean installation of Windows 11. So I formatted the whole SSD and reinstalled the laptop drivers. All drivers for this laptop are available on the Asus official page. Formatting was not difficult at all. But I found that the first version of Windows 11 had some bugs. Especially taskbar errors. I wish I had installed Windows 11 a month later. Maybe I wouldn't have these problems. As for performance tests, SSD read-write speed is at peak levels. Regarding to Passmark results that Micron Technology RAM on average level. See the Battlefield and Valorant game performance results on the top left of the screen. While the games are open, the OBS screen recording program is running in the background.
Match found.
I am both shield and sword.
You know your tricks, Wind Girl. You're not faster than me.
No charges left. Loading. Our spike's down.
Spike down, attacker spawned.
Reloading.
Ugh.
Last player standing.
That cipher thinks he sees everything. I go invisible, idiot. Come get me.
Need a drop.
Don't overthink it. That's my job.
Reloading.
Enemy spotted me.
Our spike is down.
Reloading.
Spike down, attacker spawned.
Multiple enemies A.
Yikes.
Last player standing.
Sage, we are the perfect pair. You give life.
I take it. Need a drop.
Thank you.
Draws a spike. Reloading. Enemy spotted mid. Multiple
spike down.
Enemy spotted
spike
B.
Down. Attacker spawn.
Blocking sight.
Cutting their vision.
Them from
it's time to move on to the next objective. Objective B. Objective B looks a little different because it's controlled by the enemy team. This means enemy soldiers can possibly you With the tank out of the way, you should press on towards objective B.
Next up test is our Premiere Pro video rendering test. 1080p 24 frames per second maximum 12 megabits per second bitrate video render. Almost 3 times faster render than my old laptop. By the way, the fan noise is coming from my old laptop. Asus was almost silent.